The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. Second chapter, text number 15, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Recorded on the 15th of February, 1975, in Mexico.
Yamhina Bhakanti Iti Purusam Purusarsava Samadukha Sukham Dhiram Sa Amritataya Kalpati. So, we have been discussing for the last 4 days about the constitutional position of the soul. First thing, we have discussed that the living being, this body is not the living being, but the living being is within the body. Just like the motor car is not the driver. The driver is within the motor car. Now, the driver or the soul within the body is immortal. And it is transmigrating from one body to another. So, this transmigration from one body to another is not very good business. Just like if you are living in some apartment and you have to change immediately for another, do not get disgusted. Naturally, we desire that if I get some permanent apartment, it is very good. Actually, we want that. Nobody wants to die. Even a person or living being in the most wretched condition of life, if you propose, then let me kill you, he will not agree. Therefore, the psychology is that every living being does not want to die. But actually, we are not subjected to death or birth, that will be discussed. We have some or other, by chance or by coincidence, we have acquired this material body. Actually, it is not by chance, but we wanted to lord it over the material world. Therefore, we have got this material body. So everyone in this material world, either human being or animals or birds and beasts, is trying to be the lord of the universe. Therefore, if we actually want relief from this constant change of transmigration, then we must prepare for that. We have already discussed that we can get our next life as we prepare for it. If I like, I can go to the higher planetary system. If I like, I can go to the lower planetary system. If I like, you can go to the beastly life or godly life as I desire, I will get. The Lord is situated in my heart, in your heart, and He is working. He's staying. He hasn't got to work. He's staying to see my activities. And He also understands what is my desire. Accordingly, He offers a machine. This is a machine. It is said, jantra rurhani maya. Jantra means machine. So, just like in our car, we can travel here and there. Similarly, on this machine of body, we can go anywhere. So, as human being, we should know that why I am wandering in so many places, in so many species of life, and in so many planets. Why? Can it not be stopped for a permanent life? This should be the consideration. Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, ei rupe brahmanda bhramite kono bhagyavan ji guru krishna kripaye paye bhakti lata bi. The living entity in this way, wandering in different species of life, in different planetary platforms, Therefore, this is very disgusting. So if one is fortunate, then he comes in contact with the devotee. This Krishna consciousness movement is meant for giving this opportunity to everyone. We are opening centers all over the world, inviting people to come in our place, understand the philosophy. We have got so many books, and try to save yourself from this botheration of repetition of birth and death. In order to execute this business, apparently there is little difficulty. Just like we prescribe to our members, no intoxication. No intoxication, one who is habituated to drink, to smoke, to drink coffee, tea, etc., he feels some discomfort. Similarly, we say no meat eating. So those who are meat eaters, they will find little difficulty to give up this habit. Similarly, we say no illicit sex. But one who is habituated for this illicit sex life, he feels some difficulty. So there are so many things. In the beginning, it appears to be little difficult. Actually, it is not difficult, but because we are habituated, we feel difficult. So, if you are actually anxious and serious to stop this repetition of birth and death, then we must take to Krishna consciousness. Because without Krishna consciousness, nobody can stop the repetition of birth and death. Therefore, Krishna advises in this verse that accept this little difficulty. Actually, there is no difficulty, but because you have practiced, in the beginning we find little difficulty. Therefore, here Krishna says, janghina bhathayanti ete, all these so-called difficulties, if they do not bother, give some pain to a person. Just like I am feeling difficult, I am habituated to smoke, now I am forbidden not to smoke. So I am feeling difficulty. So therefore Krishna says, so although it is not difficulty, but although one feels difficulty, still he sticks to the principle, then he becomes fit for going back to home, back to God. So, indriyani pramathani, in the Bhagavad Gita you'll find, our senses are very strong, like mad snakes. There is some statement in Vedic literature, indriya kala sattva patali, indriya, the senses are just like dreadful snakes. But there is a means to subdue the snake. It is said, indriya kala sattva patali pratkhata dhamastrayate. Means the snake may be very dangerous, but somehow or other, if you take out its poison tree, it is no more dangerous. The snake is dangerous on account of the poison teeth. So if somehow or other the poison teeth extricated, then the snake is no more dangerous. So our strong senses, snake-like senses, can be bereft of the poison teeth by accepting Krishna consciousness. So the simple method offered by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is this, chanting Hare Krishna mantra. He says personally, Cheta Darpana Marjanam Bhava Mahadavarni Nidvapanam, means by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, your heart will be cleansed. And as soon as your heart is cleansed, you can feel everything in its proper order. So when the heart is cleansed, we can understand our real position and how we are suffering and how to take steps against this suffering. This is called bhava mahadavagni nidvapanam, extinguishing the blazing fire of material existence. In this verse, it is mentioned again, dhiram. Dhiram means very sober. In the beginning, Krishna said, dhira satanamuyati, Dhira means one who is sober. He is not bewildered. Dhira means that although there is cause of disturbance, one is not disturbed. Although there is cigarette, but I should promise I shall not smoke. Although there is facility for illicit sex, I will not do it. That is called dhira. Dhira means the cause of agitation or disturbance is present there, but one is not disturbed. So, in order to advance in spiritual life, we have to become dhira. That is said here. Samal dukkha sukhama dhira. As soon as one becomes dhira, sober, this so-called material pains and pleasure does not disturb him. Then he is fit for becoming immortal. Everyone is immortal, but he is fallen in such material condition that he thinks himself as mortal. Because I am spirit soul, therefore the breathing injunction is filled. Aham brahmasmi, so hum, means I am as good as the Supreme Being, means he is eternal, I am also eternal. He is also living being, I am also living being. That means qualitatively we are one, God and we. But quantitatively he is great, we are small. So we have to realize this, that we can become eternal, immortal, all qualified like God, if we get out of these material clutches. And for this we have to become dhira. Dhira means, I have already explained, not to be disturbed, even the cause of disturbance is there. So that is the qualification of becoming immortal. So, little tolerance of the sensation, just like there is some sensation, if you have got some itches, you are feeling that I should itch. But if you stop itching, this will be cured. And if you go on itching, it will increase. Anyone who has got some experience of eating, eating is very pleasing at the time of eating. But at next time it is not very pleasing. It has created so many disturbing conditions. Therefore Shastra says that we should try to control the eating of our senses. Then he is dhira. And as soon as you become dhira, you are the first class candidate for going back to home. So there is method, there is practice, there is process. If you like, you can adopt them. Actually, there is no difficulty. And solve all the problems of your life. This is Krishna consciousness movement. Try to understand and adopt it.
That we are living in the spiritual world and full of knowledge, how can we try to lord it over? How can we try to do something which actually cannot be done? And if we are originally full of pleasure, then why
don't
we accept
that I have already explained, that although you have got the God's qualities, but you are very small. Just like a big fire and the sparks of the fire. Similarly, God is big fire and we are like sparks of the fire. When the sparks come down from the fire, it becomes extinguished. So because we are very small, I have already given you the dimension. As soon as we become out of the big fire, in touch with God, then we become extinguished. Somehow or other, if you are again go to the fire, you have your original illuminating quality, the spark. So at the present moment, somehow or other, being fallen in this material condition, we have lost our godly quality. We can cure that, just like a diseased man lost his appetite, but by treatment he can again awaken his appetite and eat properly. So we being very small, we may say small God, therefore we fall under the clutches of Maya, illusion, but it can be cured, we can again revive our original position. No, the soul is part of the soul. Lord is the super soul. So therefore, yoga practice means the soul wants to find out the super soul. Dhyana vasita tadvigatina manasa pasantijam yogina. The yogis, those are real yogis, not bogus yogis. Real yogis, they want to meditate upon the super soul. The super soul and the soul, they are sitting on the same tree, the body. The super soul is simply witnessing the activities of the soul and giving sanction for all his mischievous activities. But the soul is suffering the sequence or the result of his activities. The super soul is simply witness. That is stated in the Bhagavad, Anumanta upodrashta. Anumanta means without God sanction, without super soul sanction, you cannot do anything. But because he persists, the soul persists to do something, super soul says, all right, you do at your own risk. Just like a thief is going to steal, the super soul is ordering, don't do it. Because without God's sanction, he cannot steal. But when the thief persists, then he says, all right, you do at your risk. This is the position of the super soul and the soul.
So the soul suffers with his mind, what is he always doing?
Yes, he creates. He's thinking in his own way. Therefore, he's creating a situation which will be botheration for him.
So we have some small white poison of the sense.
Poison?
Of the senses.
Yes. Sense, because we have come to the poisonous condition, the senses have become poisonous. Just like if you go to an area where there is infectious disease, you contaminate and suffer from the disease. So it is your duty not to go such a place where there is contamination. It is up to you. You create your own situation, suffering or enjoying.
If we have not already seen the perfection, then how can the soul see the perfection and see that you have to reincarnate so many times to see the perfection?
There is no argument. If you are diseased, you can be cured. If you take the proper medicine and treatment, that's all. Disease is not hopelessness. Otherwise, why the people go for treatment to a physician? Similarly, out of ignorance you are now in this miserable condition. But if you become treated by a bona fide spiritual master, then you will be cured. Originally, every one of us pure. Now, by material condition, we are now contaminated. But there is process to get out of this material contamination, then again we become pure. And as soon as we become pure, there is no more birth, death, old age and disease. Finished. Just become Krishna conscious and Maya will not touch you. Just like you take injection, vaccine, and the infection will not touch you. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Daivitesha Gunamai, Mama Maya Durataya, Mami Vajapapadante, Maya Me Tang Sarantite. Any other question? Yes. Question?
You want to know what the symptoms of Hare Krishna?
Symptoms? He's chanting Hare, Hare Krishna. Unless one is Krishna conscious, why he'll take the trouble 24 hours, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. This is the symptom. The symptom is further explained that as soon as you see one man and you remember Krishna, that means he is Krishna conscious. So our men, wherever they go, people say Hare Krishna by seeing him only. Therefore the man is Krishna conscious. This is the proof. That is the statement of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He, by seeing one person, you remember Krishna, that person is Krishna conscious.
Why it seems that when his soul comes
in
contact with the middle
angel,
it becomes
enchanted? He wants to enjoy his material enjoyment. Just like everyone is going to the restaurant for eating something palatable. But we are not going. Somebody is going to cinema, but we are not going to the cinema. Similarly, there are two kinds of men. One is attracted, one is not attracted. Those who are not attracted, they are called Nitya Siddha, eternally liberated. And those who are being attracted, they are called Nitya Vaddha, eternally conditioned. So you will find always two classes of men. So one is attracted, one is not attracted. One who does not want to serve Krishna and wants to serve his senses, he is put into this material world. And he is given all facilities to enjoy, but he becomes entangled. This is the body. Yes?
How is devotee preserved? How is the
born under us? If you are serious, you come to us, I shall teach you. If you want to be learned man, you must go to school. You cannot learn at home.
How can you feel sanctified?
How can you feel you are dreaming in a different land? At night when you dream, you forget your this, all, everything. Your father and mother, your home, address, you are in a different place. Again, in daytime, you forget your dreaming land, you come to another place. This is transmigration. You create somebody and you see differently. This is transmigration. We are every day, every night, we are experiencing transmigration. But we have no intelligence to understand. Therefore, tad-vijñānātham sā-guru-mayi-vāvidatte, you have to go to a bona fide guru. And he will make you understand.
How can you achieve samadhi?
Samadhi? And just like if you fully absorbed in some thought, that is called samadhi. That is samadhi. If you become absorbed in thought of Krishna, that is samadhi. That's all right.